Hey everyone, it's Mary DeMuth from Pray Every Day, the Pray Every Day show. So glad to have you here. Welcome to the new listeners. I so appreciate you joining me in the middle of October here. I hope autumn is treating you well. Of course, I'm in Texas, so we won't see autumn until about November or December. So send a leaf my way if you live on the East Coast. Anyway, we're walking through scriptures from the seven deadly friendships that dropped on October 1st. These are relational scriptures. We'll be doing this until pretty much toward the end of November, where we'll pick up the Luke narrative about Jesus being born and get ready for Christmas. So today's verse comes from 1 Corinthians 6, verses 9 through 11 in the Holman Christian Standard Bible, the HCSB, and it says this: Do you know that the unrighteous will not inherit God's kingdom? Do not be deceived. No sexually immoral people, idolaters, adulterers, or anyone practicing homosexuality, no thieves, greedy people, drunkards, verbally abusive people, or swindlers will inherit God's kingdom. And some of you used to be like this, but you were washed, you were sanctified, you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. Mind if I pray for you? Lord, these are hard verses. But they're also hopeful verses because they show us what we were before we knew you, and they show us the power of the gospel at work in our lives. We used to be one way, but because of the Holy Spirit who now lives within us and beats within our chest, we are something new. The old has gone and the new has come. Lord, we don't want to be folks who are sexually immoral. And Lord, if there is something in our lives that needs to be cleaned up in that way, I pray that you would shed a holy light on that. Help us to turn away from sexual sin. Help us not to be idolaters. And that simply just means idolizing or worshiping something other than you. And Lord, I used to think that didn't really count in America in the 21st century because we didn't have these little statues we worshiped. But oh, how we worship other things. We worship fame. We worship wealth. We worship other people. We think that someone else will complete us. There's all sorts of idolatry out there. So forgive us for that. And Lord, you've talked about the importance of not being a thief. A thief is someone who takes from someone else. And in our relationships, there have been thieves in our relationships, people who have stolen from us. There have been greedy people who have exploited us. Or maybe we have been greedy in the past and we have exploited others. Lord, it talks about being verbally abusive, and it's right next to the word drunkard. And I can't help but think that so many times those two are connected. When people overindulge in drugs or in any sort of substance that alters their personality, they can either get super sweet or they can be very, very violent. So I pray for the person today who is in an abusive relationship where they are experiencing verbal abuse. And I pray that you would show him or her a way out of that relationship, a way to get safe. Lord, thank you that there are shelters around the nation in churches and in municipalities and places all over the world that will shelter people who are being abused. Lord, those folks who are abusing are not going to inherit your kingdom, but Lord, oh, how we want to be inheritors of your kingdom. We want to be people who walk in your kingdom. We want to be people of justice, of kindness, of goodness, of faithfulness, of peace. Lord, help us when there are those verbally abusive folks to know what to do, when to point it out, when to be quiet, when to turn the other cheek, when not to turn the other cheek. How to live in the midst of it, how to walk away from it. Lord, your Spirit is a great guide. And so I pray for my friend who is trying to navigate that very rocky road of a difficult relationship. And I pray that you would send people into their lives who will speak the truth to them and help them to know what to do next. Thank you that, Jesus, when you walked the earth, you found the broken, you found the victim, you found the one on the outcast or the one on the outside of the circle. Lord, you found them, you sought them out, and you loved them. And so if my friend today is feeling verbally or physically abused, thank you that you notice them. And I pray you bring them to a safe place in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you so much for listening to Pray Every Day. You are worth loving and your life is worth living. That's from my book, Worth Living. But that's really true. It's a truth that we need to internalize. If you'd like to support the show, you can go to patreon.com/prayeveryday. And there's a couple different levels there that you can support, even starting at $1. So that's a per month donation. And thanks in advance for doing that. And I hope you have a splendid day. Quick announcement, if you want to grow deeper with Jesus every day, as we've been praying these prayers every day, there's a way to do that now. We have 4 journals and they go by the season. So the autumn 92-day journal, and there's a winter one and a spring one and a summer one as well. And you can write down the scripture of the day, your own prayer, a place where you can list your gratitude and also the answers to prayer. And so this is just a way for you to take your pray every day experience and journal it for your own spiritual growth. This will help support the podcast. So just look in the show notes and you will find a link to Amazon to be able to purchase this 92-day journal this autumn. So thank you so much. And huge thanks to Tricia Goyer, who came up with the idea for me.